gets the call for game one of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Matt, in a day and age where runs are scored at an alarming rate, this guy's been pretty rock solid. Last three starts, ERA under 2.00. Not an easy thing to do, and you'll know if he's on early. If he's good and on point in the first inning, that usually means he's going to be rock solid throughout the rest of the game.
Up next for Chicago, Tim Anderson. And the home-away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Now here's a check swing, and they appeal down to first. No swing, so that's ball four.
He almost got him to commit there. As we take another look at it in slow motion, he comes awfully close to breaking that plane, but he was able to hold back. Strong wrist, and he gets a trip to first because of it.
And perhaps sensing a hit and run may be on, a move to first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. Stepping in now, Yoimer Sanchez. Grounded back up the middle. There's Segura. Hernandez at second. On to first, the double play. Now a moment here to check out the White Sox starting lineup. Who stands out to you, Danny?
You know, I'm really impressed with Yoan Moncada. He doesn't let the pressure of the big moment get to him. I love watching this guy hit in clutch situations. It's like he takes a deep breath and everything stops in front of him. He plays like the Zen man.
So here's the slugging first baseman Jose Abreu now. Career line against Jared Eichhoff. He's 0 for 5. The 1-1. Misses low. Good take on the curveball there. These Phillies, as they enter play here tonight, fellas, they begin this series feeling pretty good about the way things have gone as they come in riding a 4-game winning streak.
Hey, why not get on a hot streak, Matty? They played really well yesterday. Continue that trend. Stay on the attack. See if you can get on a hot streak. Maybe rattle off 8-10.
3-1 to him now. Into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. Now here's a drive out to right center field. And this will kick off the base of the wall. And he will pull into second with a two-out double.
When you drive the ball into the gap like that, nothing but good things can happen. Neither one of the outfielders had the wheels to catch up to it, and he glides easily into second for a double. Now we'll see if the guys behind him can get him in.
In now, Daniel Polka. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two.
Hey, I know we're only in the top of the first, but backbreaking blows are those two out, runners in scoring position knocks, and they have a chance to capitalize right here.
Boy, Dero, you touched it on it right there. I think as a pitcher, you try to get through that first inning and not have to show all of your pitches and empty out the bucket. That two out double right now, he's going to have to buckle down to try to keep this game scoreless.
Two out, base runner aboard in the top of the first. Bonnie bailed him out with a swing. 3-2 now.
You know he wants to end this inning right here on 3-2, but I don't think we'll see him lay one in on the next pitch there with a base open to work with.
Payoff pitch on its way. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Danger averted following the two-out double. It's on to the bottom of the first. No score on MLB Network. Lucas Giolito will be on the mound for the series opener. What's your take on him, Dan?
well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has that gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties? And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
Gene Segura standing in. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1. And there's a base hit on the line.
I guarantee you at release point, he wanted to pull this pitch back. Change up middle of the plate usually gets deposited in the seats.
Into the box now, Cesar Hernandez. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. With that, a look at the Phillies' batting order in this one. Thoughts, Dan, who stands out?
Well, Matt, I appreciate the way Bryce Harper plays the game. He's really had a heck of a year in the power categories, slugging over 500 coming into this one. That means almost every time he's hitting the ball, he's hitting it hard somewhere. Should be fun to watch.
So one gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And that'll bring in a dangerous hitter indeed in the form of Bryce Harper. The 1-1 pitch. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And guys, you take a look at the White Sox entering play here tonight. They come in scuffling a bit of late, just 2-4 over their last six games.
Yeah, Matty, this is one of the rare occasions where you play on the road, but you actually get to the drive to the stadium like it's a home game. I always felt like this was super odd to play in these.
Oh, hang on now. This ball is smoked to right, and I don't think this one's coming back. No chance. It's gone. Two-run home run here for Bryce Harper, number 25 for him on the year, as the Phillies have taken a 2-0 lead.
When that pitch was grooved right down Main Street, he couldn't believe it. He started salivating when he saw it, but stayed back enough to put a great swing on it.
And that'll bring up the Sacramento product, Rhys Hoskins. He's definitely a long ball threat, currently third in the National League in that category.
You know, Matty, when I think of this guy, I think of damage near the league leaders in RBIs as well, D-Ro.
That's the stat that I think gets overlooked so much in today's game. I remember back to Chipper Jones. He used to say, how many biscuits can you put in a basket? Runs and ribbies. And he certainly has a knack for being able to drive in that big run.
Here now the 2-2. Line drive to center field. Garcia is there. Two gone.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made all the difference.
So next to the plate for the Phils, JT Realmuto. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. Bases are empty here with two men out. Yeah. And a slider misses here. Two balls and a strike. But facing right-handed pitching so far this season, Real Muto has a batting line residing in the 290s, looking to boost that even higher here. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there, pretty much unable to hit any of his spots, and now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
And a fastball misses there, ball four.
Yeah, well, when a guy's swinging the bat as well as he's been, this is a smart move. No reason to tempt fate out there.
Digging in now for Philadelphia, Michael Franco. And there you see his righty-lefty splits and how they've played out so far this season. Real Muto leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And it's 1-2. Ground ball right side. Taken in by Abreu. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. But the fight and strike for a pair, both coming on this two-run home run. We'll head to the top of the second. It's now 2-0 Philly. Digging in the switch hitter, Yoan Moncada, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
A ball and two strikes. So let's take a peek at the officiating crew in this one. Behind the plate is Kenny Jansen.
You know, Kenny Jansen, Dero, he's kind of hard to figure out. Doesn't give a lot on the edges. He'll make you bring the ball into that plate.
Yeah, Dan, Kenny Jansen is definitely consistent, and he'll reward pitchers around the knees. But on the edges right there, sometimes it's hit or miss.
Now a foul tip right into the catcher's glove as he's able to hang on for the first out.
So here's how the Phillies are positioned defensively. And this team, they're not going to be moving around as much as some of the new age teams. The shifting and moving the third baseman over second base and the right fielder to play third base. This is going to be your stationary team, trusting pitchers to execute pitches.
Ready now for the White Sox, Eloy Jimenez. And he's a strong candidate for Rookie of the Year honors. If he can avoid a collapse here in the final months, it's been a great first campaign in the big leagues for him so far. The 1-1. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
That's what happens when a slider doesn't do what you want it to do. That was just one of those cement mixers, kind of just spinning but doing nothing. Nice job of punishing that pitch and picking up two bags on one swing.
Standing in now, Leury Garcia. Yep, and he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1. Turned on down the line, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. Now the 3-2 pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. McCutchen is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. Now now at the plate, James McCann. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. The 1-2. Skied in the air to straightaway left. And McCutchen will put this one away, and the inning is over. White Sox leave one. They trail it here 2-0. Here's Andrew McCutchen now, and you can see his home road splits there. He has not fared very well in front of the home crowd, oddly enough.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Well hit to right, but that's a foul ball. The next 3-2. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. And that is down, as that could be two bases. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
And this might be the kind of AB that gets him out of that slump. Smart hitting here, just going with the pitch, using the whole field instead of trying to do too much. The results speak for themselves.
Into the box now, Corey Dickerson. No career numbers to talk about for this matchup. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
He might still be thrown off from that first inning, guys. He got knocked around pretty good, and that can be hard to recover from mentally sometimes.
McCutchen stands at second with no outs. Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat, 3-1.
You know, I kind of see why his ERA is so high coming into this one. He's just putting these guys in too many good hitters' counts. That'll catch up with you real quick.
Set. Here's the 3-1. Popped him up. McCann is there. And that's the first out of the inning.
Okay, guys, here's how the Southsiders are lining up on D today. And I'm going to focus today on Tim Anderson. And when I say his name, I think quick feet. Not only defensively at the shortstop position, but also putting a defense on their heels. When he gets on base, look for him to take off. And he's got a strong arm as well from shortstop.
A man at second with one down, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Jared Eichhoff. Runner at second here with one man out. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1.
Well, these are just extra pitches that are just going to add to your pitch count. He's not trying to work around him, and no reason to, but sometimes you just lose the strike zone for no apparent reason.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Heading out towards shallow right. Ponca has it in his tracks, makes the play, and there are two gone now. Digging in, Gene Segura, runner in scoring position with two gone. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And this one's in the dirt. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. Philly shortstop in front of the count, 3-1. Two out here and a runner at second. Oh. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
We knew coming into this game that this guy has a tendency to give up a lot of free passes, and history repeats itself as he's already given up two walks here. I'll tell you, effectively wild is a pretty tough thing to be.
Ready now, Cesar Hernandez. 0 for 1 here in the early going. Yanked high and deep down the line in right. But this will land untouched. Working for the punch out and the offering. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a start that he's going to go very deep.
The 2-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Hawke is after it. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Phillies leave a couple. After two, it's a 2-0 ball game. Coming to the plate now, the pitcher for the White Sox, Lucas Giolito. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Is put in play to the right side of the infield. Played on the backhand. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. And with one gone for him in the inning, let's check out where these guys sit in the standings. And as you can see, they've got themselves a slim 2.5 game lead in the division. Digging in, Tim Anderson. Into center field, line drive, base hit. Striding in, Yomer Sanchez. Now the 3-2 pitch. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
I know one thing. He earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
So first and second with one man gone, and one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. Now a swing, and he pops him up. And I believe, yes, the umpire signaling for the infield fly rule. So two on with two away, and that'll bring forward the power bat of Daniel Palka. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses, ball two.
Two and one.
Boy, he better get it back together here quick, because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
The 2-1. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Anderson at second, Sanchez on at first with two down. And strike three called, as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. White Sox strand a couple. They trail things here 2-0.
We're back now as the Phillies prepare for their at-bats here in the third inning. And this lineup has been terrific for this club all year. Entering the day, they rank among the best teams in the league in stolen bases. A lot of teams these days rely more on big swings of the bat to generate offense. But when I asked a member of the coaching staff about their approach on the bases, he told me they're simply playing into their strengths. He said they have a lot of really athletic guys, so it would be misguided to not be aggressive and force the other guys to prove they can stop them. Something to keep an eye on as this one moves forward.
Thank you, Heidi. Here now the 2-2. This is popped up. Abreu just to the right of the mound. One out. So one gone here in the Philadelphia third, and that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Rhys Hoskins. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike. Good opposite field power here, taken high and deep to right. Falco ranging back to the track, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall, and he'll pull into second with one away.
Man, they already hit one home run, and I thought they had a second one right there. Not quite enough behind it, though, as it banged off the wall for a double. He's giving up a fair amount of solid contact right now.
Stepping in now, JT Realmuto. A swing and a ground ball to third. And that's the second out. Man at second here with two away. And that means Michael Franco, the third baseman, will bat next. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. The 1-2. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
That was a changeup, so there really wasn't any intent behind it. Looked to me like it just slipped out of his hand a little bit. That'll happen sometimes because of the grip of that straight changeup.
The 2-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Here's another 2-2. High in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Take this one over to first, and with that the inning ends. One left for Philadelphia, but they're on top 2-0. Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
If you're ever going to see a position player go to the mound, it's going to be in a situation like this. Get him to relax a little bit, focus on his mechanics, and get that fastball back in the zone. Can't allow this guy to lead off walk.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Stepping into the box, Eloy Jimenez. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate.
Yeah, give me a repeat performance of that last double. With a man on first right now, let him run, get you a ribby.
And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1.
Seems to me like they're pitching him a little bit more cautiously after that double he had his first time up.
Swing and a miss, strike two. On the ground is short. This could be two. Segura has it to second for one. On to first, and it's a double play. The second they've hit into in these first four innings, and there are two away now.
Nice job on the mound to bounce back from the leadoff walk. Those are usually pretty costly, but that won't be the case this time after the two ball.
Into the box, Leury Garcia. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Count even at 2-2. No runs, three hits, and no errors so far for the White Sox. Two pitches fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Fouled away. Line drive snagged on a short hop. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Nothing across here this half of the inning. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. Phillies on top, 2-0. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Gabe Kapler during the commercial break about the Phillies' offense. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. At the plate, Andrew McCutchen will strike things out against Lucas Giolito as we get the inning underway. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two. A 3-1 count to the Phillies left fielder. The 3-1. Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up, and that'll get down for a base hit. So the Phillies get a man on to start out the inning.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
And he's back in standing. McCutchen aboard here at first with nobody out. Into the box now, Corey Dickerson. Soft liner to the left side, but gloved by the third baseman for the out. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Jared Eichhoff. He flew out in his last at-bat. Two runs, five hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Got it back in time there, and it's 2-1.
Great decision there to pull back. Step number one in getting a sacrifice bunt down, make sure you bunt a pitch that you can handle.
Now the 2-1 pitch doesn't hit the target. It's ball three.
Yeah, now you've got a guy up there trying to give you an out by bunting. So the last thing you want to do is waste pitches and maybe put yourself in a situation where you could walk him.
The 3-1. And he'll try to bunt that man to second, but this one kicks foul. Now the 3-2 pitch. Bit of a surprise here as he's going to try to lay one down.
Now I know he struck out there, but for a pitcher, that's a pretty solid at bat. Anytime you can make an opposing pitcher out there work and throw quite a few more extra pitches, that's a quality AB in my book.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Jean Segura. It was a walk in his last trip. Now a move over to first, and he'll be back in standing up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
Hey, that's a really good pitch right there, and that's one of those off-balance swings. As a pitcher, you want to look in and say, howdy, if you're waving at me. A real ugly swing, and it gives you a lot of confidence when you make a guy look that bad. So hopefully he has another pitch left in his repertoire to bury this guy and get him out of there.
Grounded to third. Throw over to Abreu is in time, and with it, the side is retired. Phillies strand one, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. I had a chance to talk with White Sox manager Rick Renteria between innings about his thoughts on his lineup's performance. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together.
They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
All right. Thanks, Heidi. Now in the box, James McCann, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2.
You could clearly see that the hitter didn't like that strike call, and his manager, he didn't like it either, as he's given the umpire an earful from that dugout.
The 1-2. And it's fouled away. The 1-2 pitch. Inside and a hair low. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. A full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now, just rearing back and letting it go. And it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
Now to the plate, the pitcher, Lucas Giolito. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Hit down the third baseline, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
I don't know if that was discipline or whether he's just not swinging the bat at all, but hey, at least he's making the pitcher throw a few more pitches.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number 2.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
In now, Tim Anderson. 2-1 count to the Pale Hose leadoff hitter.
Might have been cheating for another fastball, trying to get the head to that one early. Pitcher pulled the string with a nasty breaking ball and had him a little bit out in front.
And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
The 3-2 pitch. And this one misses high for ball 4, and they have themselves a 2-out base runner.
Well, they've been unable to get to this guy, so they'll take base runners any way they can get him. At the very least, you make him work from the stretch and add to his pitch total.
Digging in to try it again, Yomer Sanchez. And we'll see if they can make him pay for the 2-out walk, always considered a big no-no, of course. Here's the 1-1. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike 2. Clearly trying to control the running game with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Fastball well outside. Anderson, the runner at first with two gone. He pulls this one into right. And as it turns out, the 2-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. A man left for the White Sox. They're still down. It's 2-0. So digging in now, Cesar Hernandez, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. A dive, but it's off his glove. He'll get it into second. The tag, and he is out at second. So the base is empty here with one away, and that'll bring in a dangerous hitter indeed in the form of Bryce Harper. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And he misses 2-1.
Boy, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, you have to make sure it's up above the zone like that. He can't do a whole lot with that, but if it were a little lower, he can and will make you pay big time.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Is swung on and missed for strike number 2.
He'll be kicking himself tonight if he doesn't come up with a big knock right here. That pitch was in a hittable location, and a hitter of this caliber usually doesn't let that go by.
And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
It's not that easy to make a good hitter look that bad, but that's what happens when you can bring that fastball and ride it in on the inner half of the plate right there. You can get some pretty ugly swings.
Standing in now, Rhys Hoskins. Is swung on and driven out to right center field. A ball that's well hit. Polka looks up and goodbye. This one ain't coming back. Rhys Hoskins with a solo shot. And that is 27 for him on the year. And the Phillies open up a 3-0 lead.
Well, it's not too surprising to see him go bridge here. Two outs, bases empty. That's when you see a guy change their approach, and they just swing for the fences, trying to make the inning after all, and that's exactly what he did right here.
Stepping in now, JT Realmuto. Nope. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. Two out, nobody on. Fouled off. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. High and deep to right center. Polka is in pursuit. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. But the Phils tack on one more on this solo home run. Through five innings, it's now 3-0 Philadelphia. Stepping in, Jose Abreu. And through five turns at bat, they've only mustered a total of three hits. Not terrible, but they're certainly not firing on all cylinders.
Well, it's getting a little bit too late in this game if this continues like this. In today's game, with so many dominant bullpen arms, you certainly don't want to wait until the eighth or ninth to try to wake the bats up.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Takes that one for strike two on the inside corner.
Even though he let that one go, you know that's the kind of pitch he likes to take a big hack at. Not too many power hitters that don't like a stomach-high fastball, so he's probably not throwing that one again.
The 2-2 is laid off, and the count runs full.
What a great battle to start this inning. What a great job by the leadoff hitter. He knows that this pitcher's starting to get up there in pitches. The manager's starting to get restless. Let's see if we can knock him out and get into that bullpen.
Takes this the other way to right. Harper is there, one away.
That's one of those tough luck outs that'll drive you crazy as a hitter. He drove that fastball but couldn't get it down, so he has to take hard contact as a consolation.
Into the box now, Daniel Polka. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Now to the plate, Yoan Moncada. He hits with two away as they continue to trail in this close game.
Well, Matt, this has been a big inning on the mound. He's had to face the middle of the order, and so far he's held them at bay.
Yeah, this feels like the kind of inning we'll look back on at the end of the game, even if the result of it changes dramatically here. Bases are empty here with two men out. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
This offense is going to have to find a way to get going. It's happened in the past. Every team goes through it where everyone seems to fall into a funk at the same time. Everyone needs to relax and not try and be the hero and just start getting the leadoff guy on.
2-1 pitch is a slider taken for a called strike two. A still 2-2. Now another 2-2. Line drive to left. That's his first base hit, making 1-for-2 now. So we'll go at least one at bat deeper into the top of the sixth after that two-out success.
Hey guys, he's lucky he's getting this baseball back. He hung that middle of the plate. The batter's eyes lit up and he was able to put good wood on it.
Into the box, Eloy Jimenez. Oh my, this ball is crushed. Where will this one end up?
And this is an all familiar sight, something we've seen all season long. When they need a clutch hit or an offensive blast, he's their go-to guy. And this is just one example in a long line of many. He's fun to watch.
Here's the Philadelphia manager on his way out to the mound now. And he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So as he leaves with the bases empty, he stands to be the winning pitcher here tonight if the bullpen can hold up the one-run lead. Hector Neris, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound. Standing in now, Leury Garcia. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Two out, nobody on. Right side, hit hard. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Two in the inning for the Sox, however, they come on this two-run home run. Bottom of the sixth is straight ahead. It's the Phillies 3 and the White Sox 2. Kelvin Herrera enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. So coming to the plate, Michael Franco. He'll lead things off here in the Philadelphia sixth. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
One strike.
And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike, 2-2 now.
Plain to see right there that the manager's sticking up for his hitter, making sure that that strike zone gets a little bit tighter. It's tough to cover both sides of the plate, and they both want that strike zone to be shrinked up a little bit.
Ready with the 2-2. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
Three, two pitch. And he fouls this one off. The 3-2 one more time. Now a fastball is lifted into the air to shallow center. Sanchez will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Stepping in now, Andrew McCutchen. Outside with the fastball as the count moves to 2-1 now. And some stirring now in the White Sox bullpen as it looks like a right-hander's up and throwing. 3-2 is our score here in inning number 6.
Zero.
Swung out and missed, and it's even at 2-2.
Oh, that changeup came in at 89 miles an hour. You know a guy throws hard when his off speed is in the high 80s.
Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone. Now the 3-2 pitch pulls this one in the air out to left. Jimenez is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. Riding in once again, Corey Dickerson. Past meetings with Kelvin Herrera, he's 0-4. The 1-2. This one's down to third. Throw over to Abreu is in time, and with it, the side is retired. Phillies down in order. They're up 3-2. Welcome back to Citizens Bank Park here in Philadelphia. It's on to the seventh inning now with the Phillies out in front, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first 6 innings so far. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Jose Alvarez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. Standing in, James McCann, 0-2 from him so far in this one.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul. Now a swing and a deep drive to left. And as is heard on television all throughout Chicagoland, you can put it on the board. Yes! A solo shot here to left. 7 home runs for him on the year now. And the White Sox have come back to tie it at 3. Ball's jumping in this one. That's the 4th to leave the yard so far.
Matty V, this is just one of those days where the ball seems to be flying. D-Ro, the hitter's on point. The pitchers aren't making very good pitches.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's all about executing pitches, and they're not doing it today. They're leaving a lot of balls over the heart of the plate, and this offense, both offenses, are taking advantage.
And there's a line drive. Base hit to left field.
Hey, guys, that's an excellent job right there. That's a back foot slider. Usually those are kryptonite for most batters, and he's able to fight it off, keep his hands inside the baseball, and deliver a base hit.
In now, Tim Anderson. Counts a ball and 2 strikes to the White Sox shortstop. Now some movement out in the Phillies bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. Ball and 2 strikes. Here's the pitch, and he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Hoskins is there, and he's got it for the first out. Standing in, Yomer Sanchez. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. Here's the 1-1. Outside, 2-1. Hit in the air to right field. Harper has a read on it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. So two away here is the Sox bat in the seventh, and one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. The 1-1 takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
If you're going to catch up to a high fastball like that, it's all about getting that front foot down in enough time to allow your hands to start moving forward. He was way too late there.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed. Strike three. Sox able to tie things up on the solo home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch, and we are all tied at three apiece. Evan Marshall gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Here's the center fielder, Odubel Herrera. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. One and one, here it comes. Hard hit to first. Fielded by Abreu, and a step on first himself for the out. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Gene Segura. A hit in two official trips to the plate to this point in the ballgame. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Oh, look out, hot shot to third, and there are two away. Coming to the plate now, Cesar Hernandez. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. The 2-2 will not catch the zone, ball three.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite you.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Fouled away.
If you're going to get a swing on a fastball that far in off the plate, I think you got to go right back in there or bounce something soft down and away.
The next 3-2, and he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
Here's Bryce Harper now, man at first after the two-out walk. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes, and it's fouled away. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. One left for Philadelphia. Still tied 3-3. Adam Morgan has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. So here's Daniel Ponca now, and this tie ball game is a battle of the bullpens now, and I'm sure you're enjoying that, Dan.
Bullpens are such a big part of baseball now, Matt. All these teams have such good 7th, 8th, and 9th inning guys. It all boils down to whose bullpen is better.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage of it.
You know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Ball even at 2-2. Here now the 2-2. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. A very tightly contested ball game here in Philly, as you can see by the line score. All even as we play the eighth. Into the box now, Yoan Moncada. He singled his last time up. And a 2-1 slider is looked at for a called strike two.
Talk about challenging a guy. He offered up two in a row right down the chute, and the batter didn't even flinch. Gotta wonder what he was looking for.
Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Just hung in there on that one. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll hit off the wall in left center. And he is into second base with one away as the go-ahead run.
Wow, he was willing that thing to get out of here. Would have given them the lead right here late in the game, but it ends up hitting off the wall, and he heads into second with an extra base hit. We'll see if the next man up can come through in the clutch here.
Into the box now, Eloy Jimenez. This one's down to third. And there are two away now. Stepping up to the plate, Leury García. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
The set and the 1-1 lined hard to the left side, but this will be a foul ball. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. Tried to hold up there, appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. The set and the 2-2 high in the air out to center field. Chasing after it is Herrera, and he brings it down to end the inning as the go-ahead run is left stranded. One hit, one left. home half of the eighth straight ahead, and we are all tied at three apiece. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Nate Jones will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Rhys Hoskins. It was a solo shot for him in his last at-bat.
The last at-bat, Matty V, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Two-two, here it is. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Shot toward right center. Tilson is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
I know they say sometimes that these things even out, but that was a bullet line drive that gets caught. He would have represented the go-ahead run.
Into the box, JT Realmuto. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away.
That's back-to-back breaking balls away, but now he's got himself into a little bit of a tough spot. You probably can't throw that again, so your opponent is probably up there just looking for a fastball that he can drill.
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. So a runner at first now with one away, and that means Mike Alfranco, the third baseman, will bat next. The 1-1 misses for the second ball. Now the 2-1. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Here now the 2-2. On the ground to short. Could this be two? There's one. Throw back to Abreu. They get them both, and the side is retired. Phillies go down quietly there. Score remains tied at 3-3. Coming to the plate now, James McCann. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
Yeah, that last at bat, Daddy, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
Here now the 2-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Again, he sends it out of play. Another try at 2-2. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Now the 3-2 pitch. This is hit pretty well out to left field. McCutchen going back. It's out of here, and they've taken the lead in the ninth. Santa Maria. A solo shot here to left as they take the lead 4-3. Standing 6 foot even will take over the pitching duties here. Stepping in now, Charlie Tilson.
No.
Off speed pitch, just missed inside.
And think about it, in game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
The 3-1 fouled off. The payoff pitch home. It swung on and missed, strike three.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Standing in now, Tim Anderson. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Hoskins camps under it, and he's got it for out number two. Striding into the box, Yomer Sanchez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. The 1-1 is a breaking ball that's taken for a ball. Now the 2-1 waves and misses for strike number two. One run game here in the top of the ninth. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Hey, I know the idea is to try to get the guy to swing on a 2-2 pitch, right? But that one was so low, I don't know anybody that would have swung at that pitch.
And he fouls this one off. A slider here, but this will miss off the plate away, and it's ball four.
Well, when you go with a slider there in a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
Digging in now, Jose Abreu. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more.
Let the ball
get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
It's going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
You don't see that very often against this guy. This guy has one of the best arms in the game, but still a successful steal of second base.
the set and the 2-1. And this is sent on the ground out to Segura at short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first, saves an error as the side is retired. And some dramatics here in the top of the ninth as this home run gives them the lead. Last chance coming up for the Fighting Phils. It's now 4-3 for the Southsiders. Jay Spry is the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth. Into the box, Andrew McCutchen, 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. Now the 2-1 pitch is in there for the second strike. The 2-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 2-2 one more time. Back up the middle. And that's through into center field, so the tying runs aboard to kick off the inning.
You can't ask for anything more than getting a leadoff man on right there. It brings the go-ahead run to the plate. He's in position to do some damage. It'd be interesting to see how the manager plays this one.
Phil Gosselin will come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out. McCutchen gets his lead at first, nobody out. Down the left field line and deep. And that will end up a foul ball. The 1-2. This is on the ground over to first.
Because that's one of the hardest double plays to turn. The first baseman has to deal with the runner headed to second, and he sometimes shields you from throwing where you want to make the throw. They should have made it, but that's a tough play all the way around.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Odubel Herrera, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Sacrifice attempt here, and the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out.
You can't ask for anything more than that. The tying run moves over to third now with only one out, so we'll see how the infield decides to play it here.
So striding in, Gene Segura, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. And it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk, and the force play is now in order.
Well, tough to say if that was their intention or not, but it's not the worst thing that could happen. A force at every base now, so there are a lot of ways to get out of this.
Ready once again, Cesar Hernandez. He's got the potential tying run at third, the winning run at second base. Ball four. So just like that, this ball game is tied.
And this is a great example of what happens when you can't find the strike zone. The first walk of the inning looked harmless enough, but this one brings a runner home. Self-inflicted wounds are always the hardest to swallow.
Now at the plate, Bryce Harper. He's looking to bring home the winning run from third. Possible winning run just 90 feet away here. One away. struck him out. A huge punch out there, and the winning run stays anchored in third with two gone now.
I'm really impressed by that strikeout, and I'll tell you why. He should have gotten a call on the pitch before, and it looked like he got squeezed a little bit. In a bases-loaded situation, that can drive a guy nuts, drive you crazy. What I loved is he didn't let him take it out of his game, and he came back with another good pitch and got the punch out. A really nice job of taking it one pitch at a time.
The 2-2 pitch. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been, as they'll strand the bases loaded. This side is retired. So this game will not end here in the bottom of the ninth as they push across the equalizer, and we're right back where we started from. 10th inning coming up, and we are tied 4-4. Pat Neshek takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings. And now here's the cleanup hitter for the White Sox, Daniel Polka, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
I'll tell you, he just doesn't look comfortable in the box to me tonight. He's been off balance with his swings, and that one completely tied him up.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Back-to-back sliders in on the hands. He didn't handle it real well at all on the previous pitch, so why not come right back with it again? Better job of laying off that one, though.
Here now the 2-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. To pick things up where we left off, Johan Moncada, he doubled his last time through. One out, nobody on. Hit on the ground out to short. Segura fields it cleanly, and an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow! Stepping up now, Eloy Jimenez. He's been great lately, and it's resulted in his being awarded with the American League Rookie of the Month Award. The 2-2 pitch. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he strikes him out here for out number three. So after the scoreless top half, they'll have a chance to win it here in the bottom half. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. So one will win it here as we go to the bottom of inning number 10. And we are tied 4-4. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Alex Colome comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning. So striding forward now, JT Realmuto, 0-for-2 for him to this point. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. Ball game! So it's a solo shot to dead center, and none bigger than that one as this ball game is over.
Hey, when you get into extra innings, you're always looking for that one guy to step up and be that hero. And this guy was the hero tonight. What does he do? Steps up with a walk-off home run to end this thing in extras.
So the lineup really helped carry them to victory here in this one, and this man was a big reason why. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he came through with a multi-hit game, and more importantly, they were big hits. He was a key contributor to the outcome of this one.
This evening's game comes to an end, 5-4, the final tally. Pat Neshek gets the win in relief, his second of the year. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney on the field, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network. Have a good night, everybody.